actually a great transition point to get that match started. Jason with the second serve. Goes after Datchet. McLeod bump set. Jumbo dunk by Chinese, transition swing from the middle of the court.
This is just wide.
I'll tell you what, Ludo. Going for that short angle shot, double drop, was an audacious move. One that might pay off later down the match.
Didn't pay off there, though.
Angel with the serve. Catches the top of the tape. Again, we had it handled anyway. It's a side out. Still, 1-0.
Finley rips the jump serve, handled easily, and blasts it.
McLeod with a big swing. McGinley was behind it. A little more tilt on the chest. We're probably still playing volleyball at this point.
McLeod back to serve. McLeod tags the line.
Men's pro, second round games on the right side of the court should all be started now. We want to see that action to keep the day moving. Thank you, men's open, right side of the court. Let's get it going.
This is the night that we can, bro, I got...
McLeod looking for a second chase here. Catches Genesee high, McGinley chases it down. Great effort to get a hand on it. Genesee now chasing, flies into the banner. Can't quite get the touch he's looking for, but great effort. And that is a banner of one of our wonderful sponsors, so make sure we get that fixed up.
Please write the check to Adam Brocious.
McLeod, another serve. Pump jumper on a cheesy. We get in with a nice bump set. We get a loose knuckle pokey over the top of the block, down the line, for a slide out. Right now we're trailing 1-2 as Corey Chinesi goes back to the serve.
Seth Koz does it all there, fixing banners. Back to serve.
Oh, New York. Okay, it was like an hour ago.
Nice serve. Dash handles. High pokey over McGinley, but Corey had it read. Corey returns the pokey over the block for a transition point. And that is 2-2.
I just found out.
The eagle fell down. And it fell on the camera.
Luke, I used to have an action figure I called pokey back in my day.
Just don't use it for this game.
What kind of action figure was it?
Hopefully, yeah.
It was a original 1991 Adam Brocious Pottstown Rumble action figure.
It's definitely not. Do you have any like wipes or anything?
Dache.
The bottom got bent.
Trading pokies. Alex for a big swing. Off the McGinley block.
So what happens is when it's on the tripod.
Added up at 2.
It's bent. Yeah.
So now, can you counter it?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
McGinley passes that one to the net. And puts it down cross in front of Dache.
It's a great job from McGinley to be able to generate so much power on that swing ball. The rest of his body is falling away. Clearly something you want to see from your partner when he's going for an attack.
He has a lot of power in that sweet, sweet body.
Let's see if McGinley can now transfer that power into his jump serve. Aggressive toss. Finds the seam. McLeod's able to get a handle on it. Datchet with a nice set. McLeod beats it into the cross. And a really nice swing from Mickey Mouse McLeod there.
That was just a very smooth play. Michelob Ultra, also very smooth. My favorite beer.
I'm sure you'd love one of those here under the tent, Lucas.
That would be fantastic.
Corey Chinesi delivers the topspin, finds Mikolaou. He swings about 8 feet off, 3 feet deep, and that's a switch at 3-2. Corey Chinesi looking for a second consecutive point here at the line. Side out from Deche, and now he heads back looking to even things back up at threes, because they are currently trailing 2-3.
Great math there, Rob. Great math.
That Stevenson degree is paying off, Lucas, let me tell you. Simple addition in my wheelhouse.
Tough serve down the seam. Chinesi off the net.
Great touch for the catch. Chased down by Mikolaou. Free ball back. Corey is now attacking the transition bump set from McGinley High Park. Another chase down from Mikolaou. He sets a little bit tighter.
After a long rally running all the way back to the barber sales banner, it's a tough run to make that swing. Net's just a little bit too high.
Nobody up, nobody home. You want to put that ball away. Certainly not into the net.
McGinley relief back there, serving 3-2.
Just getting a relief, he'll take a quick break as he fixes the line before putting this net serve in.
We like to call him the master of equipment, always find something to fiddle with.
Mikolaou handles. Catches, sets. High angle roll from Mikolaou earns a smooth side out for the Wisconsin man. Mikolaou's serve just catches the top of the tape. I talked to Spot Rack from Wisconsin last night, and she confirmed that the net tape set was not good there either, so I'm not sure what Mike had in mind.
Welcome to Pottstown. Chinesi grips and sends it to the beer tent. Maybe some other people should follow that ball and head right into the beer tent. Get a nice refreshing beverage.
There is nothing quite better than a Pottstown Sunday with a refreshing beverage in your hand.
Speaking of Hawkeyes delivering beer, Adam Brocious. Dolce, high off the hand. Looks like he's got springs here on Sunday.
I'll tell you what, Luke, when you jump as high as Angel is, it's pretty easy to find the top of any block here in the park, except for Chad Nolan's.
Or Nick Hunt's.
Big serve, caught the top of the tape for those who didn't see, so that's a side out.
Absolute laser, just needs to be a bit higher. McGinley must have picked the thicker blocks.
Pick block was my nickname in high school, Lucas. McGinley with the jump serve. Dache handles, he elevates. around the block, inside the line, side out.
He is tired of the pokey game. He is going all power.
The later into Sunday you get, the more swings you start to see.
You gotta dig deep out here if you wanna win that big check.
And Luke, just to remind all of our men's only players, with a big check, you need to find a big check bank to get that cash. You cannot take that to your local M&T PNC.
I think I still have Garrett Dim and Cameron Dean's check in my house.
Make it loud. With an ace, taking this score, now 4-3, they take the lead here on center court. Allow to serve, begin the handle. Again, they slaps to the ground. Side out.
Chinichi back to serve, three serving four. Niccolo handles that one. And the tomahawk, you're not gonna stop that.
I'm not sure if the Niccolo saying or slogan is always smooth, but I can guarantee you that Niccolo has proven that thus far, especially with a nice high shot such as that one.
That swing felt like it had 90 calories. Shorty, but Chinichi picks it up and swings. Ice cream scoop for everyone. And McGinley finds the court. Great rally there on center.
Dachai did a nice job making some defensive reads, but McGinley's second shot was sharp enough to earn the side out. And now he will look to tie things up at four. Allow option for Datch. Oh, one hand scoop from Chinese. Another swing for Datch. And he goes over top. Second time is the charm.
Bring a friend. Bring a friend. Also, bring your friends over to this court. We got some awesome action here. Four serving three. Niccolo Vulture back there.
Niccolo with a deep breath. Big toss, serves in the seam, Chinese handles. McGinley has him about 4 feet off the center. Gator from Datch, McLeod with a sliding kick, not enough. The Women's World Cup games don't start till noon, but we appreciate the effort.
Doug Zito would have had that yesterday, with all his feet skills.
After the side out, Corey Chinese now back to serve. Nice pass from McLeod. Dash puts him in the center. McLeod shoots to the high line.
Love to see that team camaraderie on this side.
Once college rivals, now united here trying to earn the men's open purse at the Pottstown Rumble.
Stay in or what, bro?
Corey Chinese with a jump pass. Here, shoots to the sharp angle. Datch a bit too narrow defensively. Side out. And now we have a discussion. Ryan McGinley will be heading back to serve here.
McGinley looking to tee up another jump serve. Niccolo passes up, short roll, McGinley drops and picks it up.
A lot touch from Niccolo, but they are unable to terminate after picking that ball up. So that is a point after some nice defense from McGinley and Genesee.
I'm
going to
go pick up
all the way from the service line up to block, deflects it right to Corey, and he lets it hit the ground.
That's about as much as you can hope for a block touch on a big swing like that from Angel Dash, but unable to generate an attack opportunity out of it. And now Mike Nicolau back to serve.
That's why I told Ari I was breaking right this.
Brothers Braswell, please sign. Yas Cole, Tomas Goldsmith, Chad Nolan, and Kristen Hartnett for your ring assignment. That is Brothers Braswell to the Nolan Hartnett match against Yasmin Cole. We also have a net call on the center court.
Yeah, so Duncan's five, and then the Palace.
I believe that net call was a side out, and now Corey Chinesi back to the service line, looking to he and partner Ryan McGinley in front, currently knotted up at four. Angel Dache pushed to the left side on that swing. Doesn't affect his abilities. He terminates for a side out. McGinley having some trouble with the Dache serve there. Great out of system set from Corey. McGinley says, I didn't play dodgeball for Globo Gym, but I still know the Cobra. And sneaks it on the block for a side out.
Warner.
Yo, what's up, man?
Eventually, but I have to.
McGinley dials up a big jump serve. Dache handles. McLeod with bump set. Dache. Into the hard cross. They are operating on another elevated plane of existence that most people can only dream of reaching. Vertically, that is.
All right, what's
actually Lau serve gets another pass from Chinesi. Transition swing from Dash, dug by Chinesi. Chinesi now with a chance to save side out, dug by Dash, who has another transition attempt. He rises, short angle shot for a point. Great defensive effort by both sides.
And so Dash much excitement.
That's it. With a cutting.
We want more of that. We want more of that.
And Glau will now dial up the serve to see if we get another round like that here. Pace to the air. See. Easy. On the left side of the court, use that left hand. Use the thumb down. Snaps towards the line. Very well done. For a side out.
Nicolau took off like he was running for one of those guava beers.
If you haven't tried that guava beer yet, I suggest you hustle the beer tent and get a sip because it is delicious and it will not last long.
Or just save it for us.
I like where your head's at, Lucas. Dash angles. Option ball. McGinley with a nice soft block drop bait that almost was able to get the ball back over the net. But side out for Nicolau on the 2-over. Chinesi's in the deep without a second thought, and that's a side out. McGinley heads back to the line, looking to tie this up at five, and initiate the side switch.
I'm sure it's going to get heavy.
Come on. We can only be so lucky. And he delivers one of the same tight pass from Dash, Nicolau handles very well. Dash elevates. Inside out.
The love when your partner gets down on his knees and just calls your shot.
I'll tell you what, Luke. I wish I had a partner who would do that for me. That serve catches the top of the tape for a side out. Wobbe is flowing, so are the jump serves. Cody's fly is a bit too long. We can do a side out, and now Angel is having a discussion about who the next server is. It looks like he will be the next in line.
Now, do you think the grunt helps more with your power rock?
It doesn't hurt, that's for sure. Serve from Dodge, and a bunch of DC. Beginning with the bump set. Corey drops the elbow, rolls it online for a side out. Well done. And he's steady. 4-5.
Smells like a
fireman. That's a place. That high. You get questions.
Thank you very much.
Line and Gidley. Serve. That's right, Daniels. Ooh! The option ball. Gidley, who is a full-time block right now, not able to get up to the net. Nicolau takes advantage, puts it away for a simple side out.
It was on the tripod over by the Eagle.
What? Wait.
Yeah, I know.
The Eagle fell over?
Yeah.
What
it's good with
the angle. From Mike Nicolau. Ryan does a great job of chasing down to Corey. Corey rolls high angle. Nicolau now handles more attack in transition. He takes an approach on a tight set. Oh, and we have.
No, I think it's all right. The bottom is.
We have some discussion about what was going on. Elijah Porter and Scott Trumbauer both believe that the ball was slung out of bounds. So no transition point for Nicolau and Dasha. And that'll be a side out for Gidley and Chansey. Great job of them making it work.
No, the video
on a pass that starts a perilous point.
One of the Beck brothers. Can we get a score check back there?
Dude, that sucks. That's probably an expensive
one.
Definitely not cheap.
That's a huge block for a side out.
Yeah.
And we have an update from court one. Hudson and Lucas currently lead Cap Miller 8-7. So if you're on the bleachers, make sure you've got that hip swivel open so you can get it to match it on both courts. We have a commercial timeout here on Center Court. Our players are staying hydrated, but are you? Let's talk about some of our wonderful vendors where you can work that out. We've got a lemonade stand, Oritos, we've got regular drinks, and of course we've got the beer tent. If you are purchasing one, I suggest you don't pour it all over your face just like Mike did though, because that'll get expensive fast.
Yeah, I was stranded.
Yeah, like, there's a difference. So yeah.
We have play resuming here on Center Court. Into that day. I'm sure. Leading 6-4. Big jumper. 5-40. Corey handles three clubs out of the line. Casing for the high line. Oh, Corey is very, very comfortable going high line.
20 year old.
He's going to use that shot.
Yeah. Side out. A whole different world.
practice and rehabilitation of Pottstown and Exton to 4 p.m. today to get adjusted or massaged. There's some great people over there that do some great work.
Look, I think I picked you up for massage tent yesterday, if I remember correctly.
You did. I was adjusted, and it did not help my play.
You need some skill as well.
Bigelow handles that tough serve. Shoots it over the line. Very smooth for Bigelow Ultra.
It might be always smooth, but it certainly is Bigelow. And he heads back to the line, looking to get a side switch and take his team in double-digit scoring.
Yep, that big block.
Well, it's like, this is your first time,
you're like, it's all over.
Great take from McLeod, but it goes over, so now Gilly has a transition swing. Short angle, McLeod led high line, sets a side out. Ryan nods, that's a great set, Corey. And now, Ryan heads back to serve, or we discuss some strategy.
Are you out or are you coming in?
Okay. Good experience.
Corey, okay. The line, receives the signals, says I like that, heads for a jump serve, big cloud, excellent pass, dash up, great set, big cloud, big sharp angle, much like a sharp cheddar cheese, it's like a cheese curd from his home city, Wisconsin, out here all the way playing the Pottstown Rumble, the first time ever, here on the center court. Heads over to action back here in center court. And the back serves the 45.
Drop it. Janici puts it right up the seam.
I'll tell you what, Lucas, when you get to the time of the day, you've got to trust the out of system setting is going to be strong. So the drop needs to be a little bit more patient, otherwise you're going to end up with a ball down the throat.
McGinley used to play with Nate Ocasio. His motto is he never makes a bad set.
How am I walking? Yeah, yeah,
Sam Alvis, can we get a score check back there?
We have 10-10 from Sam Alvis and another young man over there. So Pat Miller beats Lucas at 10-10 on court one. Make sure we have some action on both sides.
I love action on both sides, but he's 11-10 now over there.
No, but you know what? It could have been worse.
I have a place at the bottom of the
game. Sebastian serve outside the body to the right. Smite deep. Does not get the contact he was looking for. That goes deep. Point right. Give it to Genesi. And we are now at 6-10.
Nice.
McGinley moves to left back for the serve. Deep down the sideline, outside of Dash's right again. That's a second consecutive ace, and the crowd is loving that one. 7-10 there on the scoreboard now.
Uno, dos, ace, ace, ace.
Dude, is that the cheer you teach your club girl when you're coaching during winter season?
The boys at Satterton High School.
I was like,
Danny,
come on, play.
And I started her. Yeah. Danny lines up another serve. Goes to McLeod this time after the success on Dash. McLeod goes to the center, beats it into the McGinley defense. McGinley gets a slight touch, but not enough. And that's a side out as Mike McLeod goes back to the line. Miss there for McLeod, although the taste of McLeod Ultra never misses. And now Corey Genesi back to the service line.
Also, make a practice in line version. That's been a bit of a birthday for
speaking of Brinkley, McGinley's hands on the blocker are a bit too hard there. McLeod gets it to side out. Serve from Dash. McGinley has no pop. Sets tight. McGinley forcing through. McLeod keeps it up. Left hand over. We don't know who's blocking, but now Dash stays up. He drops it and shoots high line over the block for a harder side out. Escaping from some pressure there. Seth Kaz, we have Deep TV looking for you. Ryan McGinley at the line. The ball in, McLeod handles. Dash with a nice set. McLeod beats it to the cross for yet another side out on a patented hard swing. Mike McLeod from left back. He serves leading 10-7. And then shoots with the hard cross. Gives McLeod a taste of his own medicine. He's the hard cross. Unable to handle. Side out. Corey Genesi at the line. Defense. More useful in football than volleyball, Luke.
And I did not like it.
And I don't think they did either, because that was a transition point for Genesi and McGinley, who have earned all 3 points so far on the side and have a lead shrunk to 2, trailing 8-10. And then there's a moment where he looked like he was going to put it back towards the line, but turned that wrist away. It landed. McGinley asked about a potential net. Elijah Poore and Scott Trumpbauer, two of the premier volleyball coaches in Pennsylvania, both wave their heads no and say, there's nothing to ask about that. All parties agree that there was net contact this time, just with the ball rather than a person. And that's a side out. Henry back to the line. Speaking of net, McGinley says it's my turn to find the top tape. And it's a free side out. I'm not sure quite why Angel and Mike are hugging, but they seem happy regardless. And now...
Well, they're happy because it's a side out.
Oh, Lucas, now I follow along.
And now they've between Stennis and Angel.
And ball, Juicy handles, he approaches, shoots hard cross, Nicolau has the touch, and he is clearly frustrated, he was unable to control. Juicy looks pleased as they side out, and he heads back to line to serve.
Damn.
Men's Open playoffs. We have four matches to announce that should be starting soon. We will give the matchup and the work team. We have Baker and Wiggins taking on Frazier and Danny Cruz. Chad Nolan, you are on that match. Additionally, we have Kelly Dines versus Pamela Donahue. Travis Moyer, you are on that match. We have Ryan Charmin and John Evans taking on Landon and Miracle. Jamie Martin, looks like you are on that match. And lastly, we have Jerry Morgan, his partner, taking on Ben Corian and Martinez with John Cunningham.
That's the first show, so you gotta be making it work. Yo, Rob. You guys remember Rob?
Yeah. Oh, no, it's okay.
Maybe we'll just want
to record something. All I can do is go.
That is a big 5 points on that Rumble Man side for Shinichi and McGinley.
Yo, I'll accept the money for you guys.
We're gonna take another social timeout. We got an all new ball game here. 10-10.
Jack Weber, Matt Dreyer, Colin Dunby, please report to your court. It is time to play. Jack Weber, Matt Dreyer, Colin Dunby, junior court. They are ready to compete.
It's not all bad.
After our fourth social timeout of the match, it's getting hot here on second court. Even the officials are grabbing some beverages. Elijah Porn doesn't mean too about staying hydrated. So, Corey Chinesi, after getting all 5 points in the Roman Man side, serves this match knotted up at 10. Sam Alvis, speaking of scores, what do we have going on in court one? 12-12 on court one. If you are on center court, get over here so you can check out 12-13 now. We've got a great 14. They're scoring points at a rapid pace, according to Sam Alvis. Bates is leading. So get over and check both out.
Finds the deep corner there. Big, big, big side out.
And Lucas, I'll tell you what, after watching Chinese and McGinley earn all 5 points on that side, I'm sure Miklau and Dajé are saying we can do the same now that they're on the inside.
It is a race to five.
Nice.
High line from Ingo Dajé. Miklau fired up.
Big point there.
Huge transition point as they lead 11-10.
You like that taco?
Actually, a huge serve after that transition point, and now the lead is doubled.
Now
12-10, 3 points away from closing this one out.
Now, I don't believe in luck or skill, really, but do you only score points on that side of the court?
The last 7 points have said that is currently what the trend is. McGinley, double axe angle overhead. Nice pump set from Corey. Great dig from Dajé. He now the chance to turn into it. And he puts it away. That's three straight. And Miklau is fired up.
I would block that guy. He is on another planet right now.
Luke, I've seen you block. If you jumped in the net, he wouldn't even notice.
My face still hurts from Doug yesterday.
A quick break from the action on Southern Court. Let's get an update from correspondent Sam Alvis in the field, who says we are still at 14-12. Hudson Bates and Eric Lucas leading Nate Miller and Ian Cat.
After our fourth timeout here on center court, he would recommend that you turn and look at that game behind us because they don't take timeouts.
During this break in the action, I also want to remind you, we have more action coming in soon on the center court. I believe we will have the Women's Open Finals coming on next.
Hudson Bates and Eric Lucas still up 14-12 over Cap and Miller.
But we have action live here on the court. 13-10, Angel Dajé at the line. Jumps under the seam, she's with good footwork to handle. Jimmy bump set, move it off. He tries to go high line jumbo, but he misses deep. We are now at 14-10. Set point here on center court for Mike Miklau and Angel Dajé, the boys of Conference Carolina fame.
Back to serve for advancing to the next round. Short putty. Shinichi doesn't feel the pressure, he just puts it away.
And Luke, I'll tell you what, Ryan did a great job of communicating angle for the swing. Corey trusts his partner, put it away. It's always important to trust your partners.
I wish I could.
And Luke, remind me, you played with Adam Brocious, correct?
That's a rumble winner of 1917.
And that was a watered down field because of the war.
John Cunningham and Sunshine, Ed Jensiniak. Ooh, I apologize. Jared Werner.
And Shibataru.
I'm okay with the tripod.
I guess they don't teach you how to read or listen.
Here, you want
to
see?
What I can confirm that.
So this is kind of...
the thing with this camera is it's not very stable.
Mike McGlau. Leading 14-11, we missed the sign switch.
You know what I mean? Obviously, it's not ideal.
Breaking the screen, 9 straight points, scored on the level grand side.
Hopefully, when I go home, I can just fix it or something.
Breaks that out from McGinley. If history tells us anything, they might be able to close the gap serving here from the good side with our men's open playoff bracket, gigantic ball of American Eagle, and Rumbleman. Sam Alves with the update from center court. We are not up at 14. They're on court one between Bates and Lucas. Two great men's open matches. Make sure you check those out. McGinley grabs it. That is 14. These matches are coming down to the wire. If you aren't already set up in your seat, get over here and grab one.
That's two finger wags from McGinley.
I think that's what he normally does to Josh Farman and Luke Pinto when we set him up in the Mets for the East Coast volleyball tournaments. Aren't regulation. Dasha handles. Elevates. It's a bit behind him. He goes for the short volley. Corey picks it up. McGinley with a great transition set. Corey shoots short himself. Nicolau now has a chance to attack in transition. He rises. He swings hard. He finds the line. Nicolau has done a great job of staying aggressive on all of his swings. And on court one, we have an update. Hudson Bates now leads 15-14. No!
No tomorrow morning.